What version of you are you living? What other people say about you is none of your business. What other people think about you is none of your business. What other people believe about you is none of your business. If you're like me, these were mind-boggling statements. Hi, my name is Elisha Simon. I'm a health coach, and I work with individuals who are serious about making real change and want to elevate their life. I teach them how to dream big, but start small, and how to shed old physical and mental weight that creates a life of optimal health and inspire others. Growing up, I was fairly active. I did, however, avoid playing any sport that ended in the word ball, but I loved to dance, and I took ballet and was on a competitive dance team for 12 years. When I graduated high school, I joined the gym, and I was naturally drawn to the group fitness classes. It took a little while for me to actually go out onto the weight room floor, but once I did, I was hooked. I became obsessed for the good and the bad. I'd come home from work and I would pore over bodybuilding.com and buy all the Oxygen and Hers magazines, looking for that perfect workout and that perfect meal plan. I had this internal dialogue that if I could just look like the woman in these magazines, I would be happy. And no matter what I did, I just never felt good enough. I spent 29 of my 34 years managing the thoughts, perceptions, and beliefs of others. I did not want anyone to think or believe that I was not a righteous, hardworking, committed woman of God. In fact, I was so committed to this belief system, come hell or high water, I was not going to have anyone think that I had an untidy home, an unkept child, wasn't a perfect mother, wife, daughter. The list really could go on and on. Basically, I didn't want anybody to think that I didn't have my crap all together, and my health and fitness fell right in line with this. I never considered breaking out of those boxes of expectations, perceptions, and beliefs because I just didn't even know they existed. It was painfully exhausting, and I remember praying and sobbing to God at night for just never being perfect enough. During this time, I experienced a lot of loss in a short amount of time. My best friend since fifth grade lost her mom, and she was like a second mom to me. Then I lost a cousin who was only 36, and 9 months later I lost my dad, my rock, and had a huge hole in my heart. Then a short while later I lost both my grandparents, and then another really good friend lost her dad. There's nothing quite like death to shake you to your core and make you realize what really matters in life. I went to my friend's dad's funeral, and it wasn't just a funeral, it was a true celebration of life. I heard stories upon stories of this amazing life that he lived, and I walked away with it with just one thought in my mind. I'm not going to die an unlived life. Soon after that funeral, I turned 30, and I joke I had a midlife crisis. I even bought a bright cherry red Lexus convertible. Truthfully, I hope I don't die at the age of 60, but for the first time in my life, I gave myself permission to do what I wanted. For the first time in my life, I gave myself permission to be me, to love me, to live for me, to break free from the boxes of conditions, expectations, and perceptions of others, and realize that I'm stronger than any perception or belief that anyone has about me. It was liberating. I am so much happier now, and the biggest difference is my mindset. I started loving me and stopped looking outward for validation and approval. When I changed my mind, I changed my life. I now coach clients how to transform and elevate their life and let their confidence shine. My program is for someone who needs more than just a gym or home workout routine. It's for the person who's ready to change unhealthy patterns physically, mentally, and emotionally, but needs structure, guidance, and support. I'm here to tell you that your dream body is not in the next diet or meal plan that you buy. It starts in your mindset and what you are choosing to allow. It's built on a series of tiny habits that you can always control. I want you to make yourself a priority. Life is too short not to wake up and live your life to the fullest every day. You are deserving of all your dreams, and the more that you love who you are, the less that you will seek validation and approval from others. I'm Elisha Simon, and I want you to fall in love with yourself. You are worth it, and when you change your mind, you change your life.